about my business and ready to save the world. I'm faking my misery, making my bitch can be everyone's favorite girl. So take aim and fly away. I've never been so wide awake. No, nobody but me can keep me safe. And I'm on my way. The black moon is on.
Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all fine and safe at home. Children, welcome back to Science e-learning class. Children, are you ready? Okay, let's begin our class. Children, in the previous class, we have learned about adaptations. Changes in the feature or behavior of an organism that help it to survive in its habitat are called adaptations. Different types of animals show different types of adaptations. It may be in their body coverings, their organs for breathing, their ways of movement, or their eating habits. Today, we are going to learn about organs for breathing. All living beings need air to live. Oxygen burns the food they eat and gives energy to do various activities. Land animals take in oxygen from the air, whereas animals living in water absorb the oxygen dissolved in water. Human beings and sheep breathe through their nose. From the nose, air is carried to special organs called lungs. Human beings inhale. Inhale means taking oxygen from the air. This fresh oxygen rich air reaches the lungs from the nose through the windpipe. The lungs are richly supplied with blood vessels. Oxygen from the air is absorbed by blood in these blood vessels, and carbon dioxide from blood is exhaled, means gives out, into the air. Reptiles, birds and mammals breathe through lungs. Whales and dolphins are mammals. Though they live in water, they breathe through lungs. Fish have special structures called gills through which they breathe. Most aquatic animals like fish, prawns, crabs and oysters breathe through gills. These animals take in oxygen rich water through their mouth. Gills, the special organs for breathing in aquatic animals, are richly supplied with blood vessels. When water flows over gills, the blood in the blood vessels absorbs oxygen dissolved in the water and releases carbon dioxide, which goes out of the body along with this water. A frog can live both on land and in water. On land, a frog breathes through its lungs, and while in water, it breathes through its moist skin. Earthworms also breathe through their moist skin. Insects like grasshoppers and cockroaches breathe with the help of a series of tiny holes along the sides of their bodies. These holes are called spiracles. The spiracles lead to air tubes called tracheae, which form a network and reach all the tissues of the body. Oxygen rich air enters the body of the insect through the spiracles into these tubes. Oxygen is absorbed directly by the tissues in the tracheae, and carbon dioxide is given out, which is expelled out from the body through the spiracles.
Organs for breathing. Different types of animals have different organs for breathing. Human beings and sheep breathe through their nose. From the nose, the air is carried to a special organ, called lungs. Fish have special structures called gills through which they breathe. Frogs and earthworms breathe through their moist skin. Frogs also breathe through the lungs, when on land. Insects such as grasshoppers and cockroaches breathe with the help of a series of tiny holes along the sides of their bodies. These holes are called spiracles.
Next, organs for movement. We all know that animals move from one place to another in search of food, water, shelter, and to protect themselves from their enemies. Different animals have different organs for movement. Some animals living on land move using their limbs. Animals such as cows, dogs, cats, camels move with the help of their four limbs. The two front limbs are called forelimbs, and the back limbs are called hind limbs. Cheetah, lion, and tiger have soft padded feet so that they can silently attack their prey. Human beings walk upright with the help of their two legs or lower limbs. Their upper limbs are called arms. The skeletal system and the muscular system help in all kinds of movements of a human. In birds, the forelimbs are modified into wings, which help them to fly. The wings are attached to breastbones with strong muscles. These muscles help the bird to flap its wings during flying. A bird uses its hind limbs for walking, running, and hopping. Birds change the direction of their flight using their tail. They have light and hollow bones that help them in flight. Birds like penguin, emu, ostrich, kiwi cannot fly because of their heavy body and weak wings. They are known as flightless birds. Snakes do not have limbs. They have broad plates or scales on the underside of their bodies. These plates, along with strong muscles, help them to move. Frogs have webbed feet to swim in water. When on land, they hop with the help of their long and strong hind limbs. The short and stout forelimbs help to land safely. Fish, dolphins, and whales have special structures on their bodies called fins, which help them to swim. Fins help in movement and balancing. The two paired fins help the fish to swim and move forward. The unpaired fins help in balancing. The tail fin helps in changing the direction of movement while swimming. Fin-like structures in penguins and seals are called flippers. Penguins can walk on the snow with the help of their short hind limbs and webbed feet. Their forelimbs are modified into flippers, which help them to swim. Nose, lungs, skin, and spiracles are some of the breathing organs in animals. Legs, wings, scales, fins, and flippers are some of the organs for movement in animals.
Organs for movement. Animals move from one place to another for food, water, and shelter. They also need to escape from enemies. Different animals have different organs for movement. Animals such as horses, cows, dogs, and cats move with the help of their forelimbs. The two front limbs are called forelimbs, and the back limbs are called hindlimbs. Human beings walk upright with the help of their two legs or lower limbs. Their upper limbs are called arms. The skeletal system made up of bones and the muscular system help in all kinds of movement in the human body. In birds, the forelimbs are modified into wings that help them fly. Birds also have hollow bones which further helps them in flying. Snakes do not have limbs. They move with the help of scales present on the underside of their body. Frogs hop around using their strong and long hind limbs. They also have webbed feet that help them swim. Fish, dolphins, and whales have special structures on their bodies called fins, which help them to swim. Fin-like structures in penguins and seals are called flippers.
Children, copy the notes in your science booklet. Define the following. Molting. Shedding of skin to acquire a new one is called molting. Adaptation. Changes in the features or behavior of an organism that help it to survive in its habitat is called adaptation. Fins. Fish, dolphins, and whales have special structures on their bodies called fins, which help them to swim. Flippers. Fin-like structures in penguins and seals are called flippers. Number 5. Explain with examples the different kinds of breathing organs found in animals. Different types of animals have different organs for breathing. Human beings and sheep breathe through their nose. From the nose, air is carried to special organs called lungs. Fish have special structures called gills through which they breathe. Frogs and earthworms breathe through their moist skin. Frogs also breathe through lungs when on land. Insects such as grasshoppers and cockroaches breathe with the help of a series of tiny holes along the sides of their bodies. These holes are called spiracles. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.